Take a look at the banner down below. Reign of Terror. That's pretty strong words. My next guest is about to share the dais with the governor for the big moment. It's all coming later this hour, but he is clearly no fan. Richard Cody is a Democratic state senator and a former New Jersey governor himself. He is live despite this awful weather. Governor, thank you so much for being with us. But wow, when I read some of the things that you said in an interview to Salon, I was astounded at some of the, I'm going to say hyperbole, because a reign of terror is pretty darn strong. And things like there's been an absolute cover-up, the arrogance, the governor should be totally destroyed. Do you regret using any of this very strident language?
I don't know. I use that kind of language. What I said is that there's been abuse of power, and clearly there's a cloud over Trenton, and it results not from the way we think of corruption in terms of somebody enriching themselves. No, the governor would never do that, or the lieutenant governor. But there's a clear abuse of power here, and there's a lot of fear, and that's what's happened over the last 4 years. If you don't agree with the governor or the administration, they're going to get you. And that's what happened over in Fort and Lee, and that's what happened over in Hoboken. If you're not on board, we're going to get you. Simple as that.
Senator, I'm just concerned when you make such sort of categorical accusations that there has been a cover-up here. There's no proof at this point that leads directly to the governor. And I'm sure that having worked amidst the law for as long as you have, you know that those claims just won't hold up in any kind of court. Why would you be so definitive?
I don't know where you got...
I didn't know where you get those.
But I haven't spoken to Salon in a long time. But in any event, the incident that happened out in Fort Lee... clearly goes to the top people in the administration, and this new allegation from Mayor Zimmer goes to almost the very, very top when we're talking about a lieutenant governor. And yesterday, unfortunately, she didn't even answer questions from the press. Ms. Zimmer had made herself available to the press. She has journal entries. She has aides that said, yeah, right after that conversation, she told us what the conversation was. These are very serious, serious things. They have to be thoroughly investigated, and it's going to take a while to these two investigations to unfold. And we'll see who remains and who doesn't remain as time goes by.
Okay, so I'm going to read a direct question from the magazine and an answer from you. Do you believe the governor directly instructed that these lanes be shut down?
I did not speak to Salon magazine, so
it's quoting you as saying no, but at the very least, this could have created a climate. But again, there's a difference between a climate and a direct accusation that there's a cover-up. So are you saying that this reporting in Salon is just 100% off base?
Yeah, as I said, I have not spoken to Salon in a long time, but if there is a climate of fear here in Trenton. I've said it before, and I'll say it right now. No question about it.
Well, it's intriguing, to say the very least. I appreciate you taking the time, especially with the weather the way it is, to speak with us, and especially on a day where you have other duties as well. Senator, thanks so much.
Thank you very much.